Hey guys, welcome to episode number 62 of 10 Minute Kick-Ass Coaching. Here today, I'm heading out on the road. I've got some personal things to take care of today, and I'll discuss a little bit more about that later on. But I wanted to come to you here early because I wasn't able to get an episode out yesterday. It was kind of chaotic. Today, I'm going to talk about partnerships, or some call them joint ventures, depending on what field you're in. If you're in the marketing field, if you're in the business field, usually joint venture is a pretty common term, but I like to call them also partnerships. And is it very, very important to your business to have that partnership relationship? Well, it doesn't really matter if you own the business or your sales rep or whatever that you happen to be. It doesn't make a difference, as I say all the time. It doesn't matter. They do matter. To have those relationships. Your whole business is based on the fact that you know certain people that can influence your life. The old 80-20 rule, the adage is that 80% of your customers or 80% of your business is going to come from 20% of your customers is very, very true. When you partner up with people that have a circle of influence, much like yourself, that you may have a circle of influence to, your business will grow much better, much faster, and much more complete. So think about the fact that you need to have those partnership relationships with people. Think about the fact that you need to have, and who do you currently know that can help that situation? I have a colleague of mine that runs a pest control business, very, very nice operation, top-notch, high-end, as good as they get. And it wouldn't matter what business I think they were in, by the way. I think just pest control is what they chose to go into many years ago. But they're obsessed with customer service, obsessed with doing the right things, obsessed with maintaining client satisfaction reviews. So they do it right. So speaking to them, we were talking about a division of their business, which is a little bit away from pest control, but semi-related, of where those relationships can go. What are they maximizing right now in their current client base, and their current book of business to validate where you can get those relationships from and where can you use them. And turns out they have some relationships with some of these people that can refer their service that are somewhat joint ventured already with them, but they haven't really maximized it. So the point of this entire discussion of episode number 62 is to think about personally who you have that you can joint venture or partner with in your business. In the restoration business, we have multiple different partners. We have agents, we have plumbing contractors, we have general contractors, we have roofers, and so on and so on. I think we figured out there's about 10 different streams of income that we can work with, and we've only really maximized maybe 2 out of the 10 where we're using them consistently, working with them consistently over and over again. And maintaining that relationship with them in order to work with their customers and clients in a partnership basis. Some don't like the joint venture term, and I understand that, but it is at the end of the day the same thing. And if you have a customer client, are you better off referring somebody that you know is good? When it comes to situation, it turns out absolutely you are better off referring somebody good. I have a customer right now that we did work for that has a small amount of contracting work to put her house back together. They really need somebody, but I can't find somebody to do the work because it's so small. And that's frustrating from all sides, from her side, my side. I wish I really could help her. Unfortunately, I can't. It's not what we're about, not what we know how to do. But we certainly tried to help her out. We have tried to help her out because of the size of the job. It's very difficult. But making sure you have those joint venture relationships, those partnership relationships, people where you could pick up the phone and say, you know what, I have this small job. I know it's not much. I know you're really not making any money on it, but we refer you work other times. Is there any way you could possibly help her out with this situation? I mean, you're going to get paid for it. You're not going to get paid a bunch of money onto it, but you will get compensated for your time. It's not like you're doing it for free or any of those things. So realize the power of those joint venture relationships or partnership relationships, that they have the ability to refer you to their customers, to their clients, and the people they have it, or other people that they know. So going back to, again, the person has the pest control business, we found out the division of their business is only marketing 1% of. Now what if we take and we figure out how much we can get at least 50% of the referrals from each place we know, whether that person be in the real estate market, whether that person be a home inspector, whether that person be another restoration contractor, whether that person be anything. We got to identify what those target markets are for joint venturing, for partnering up with, and then build a lucrative relationship where we compensate them for the referrals. There's nothing wrong with that. Doctors do it across the board, and people do it across the board. And to me, it's better to put the money on the person that is opening the relationship, opening the door for you. Without that, you'd have a much tougher time getting in the door. It's very simple. You know, a lot of people are obsessed with advertising and the internet, and I'm going to do my pay-per-click campaign. I'm going to do whatever it happens to be. And that's great, and that's awesome, but you have no relationship. And when I say no relationship, you don't have a relationship immediately with anybody anyway, but the person that's referring you into the house does have a relationship with that person. The company that owns that does have a relationship with that person. So because of that, you now have a warm lead, a warm prospect, and somebody that is very willing to talk to you, and most likely very willing to hire you because of that joint venture relationship, because of that partnership relationship. Without that, you wouldn't have that. And again, if you're doing it on the internet, all they've got is maybe you've got a good website, a picture of yourself, some good reviews. That's going to help you, but it's not always going to matter. So a joint venture relationship or a partnership relationship adds that personal touch to it, adds that warm feeling to the relationship, to the transaction, where everybody there is comfortable with working with you and or your company when it comes to situations. Sales reps are no different than that. If you're in the sales rep position, you want to joint venture with people or partner with people all the time in order to maximize their opportunities. You have a product or service that somebody else can utilize, and you need to make sure you can get in and work with those clients and those prospects. And the number one way to do that is to partner or joint venture with them. So partnering and joint venturing is very, very crucial to the success and growth of yourself, your business, your sales force, whatever that happens to be. Making sure that you are developing and maintaining those relationships is key. How important is it to maintain it? You can never take advantage of it. So if you went through the struggle from day one in order to get that relationship, in order to get that person to start working with you, then you need to make sure you fight just as hard every single time to maintain the relationship. Because if you don't, they're gone. It's that simple. They're gone. Somebody else is going to come in the door that's going to say, I can give you what this person built. Now you've already done it for them. You built the platform for them, so they know how the system works. They know what good customer service, good client service already is. And if you screw it up, it's out the door for naught. It makes no sense to it. You literally just took them and you handed them over to your competitors. So make sure in a joint venture relationship, even though you've got them, that's not the end of it. Means nothing at the end of the day if you're not willing to maintain and follow through and do exactly what you do every single time, as I famously say, without excuses, consistently. Because they may take it on the chin the first time they have a problem with it, most won't, but let's just say they take it on the chin the first time and say, okay, it was a mistake, no big deal, we know these guys, we work with them all the time, they're great. The second time's not going to be that same response. They're going to go, there's a problem, there's a crack in the foundation, there's a crack in the dam, and I'm not going to stick around to wait and figure out, you know, where that other crack might start or when something else may happen. So figure out 100% how you're going to maintain that relationship. Once you've built up a joint venture, you're golden, and now you have to maintain it. You have to make sure it's cultivated. You got to make sure you flower, you water the plants, so to speak. You got to make sure you make sure that they have what they have and what they need in order to work with you and maintain and refer your service. So guys, that's today's episode number 62 of 10 Minute Kickass Coaching. How important is partnerships? Or in the business and marketing world, joint ventures, how important is that? And does it make an impact on your bottom line? Absolutely, it does. So find out and think about who you can partner with. Who are partnership businesses that you can work with that can refer your company to their client base? Non-conflicting, of course, something that matters when it comes to making sure that you have the opportunity to speak to their people. In the marketing field, it's very simple. One person joint ventures another person. They bring the person on. They do a webinar. They do whatever there happened to be, and they've introduced the other person to them. It's no different in the business world. I'm not going to get into the marketing or internet-based world. I'm going to get into the business world that is face-to-face service. Somebody, technician going into the house doing work for somebody, which is what I specialize in. That's where the joint ventures to me are the most important, is what your technicians or what you're doing when you go into a house and how you maintain that and how you cultivate and develop that relationship. And a quick story real quick, and I've talked about this a couple different times. In fact, I just talked about the other day. I had a relationship with somebody that I did work for in their house, and they were so impressed with the way we did the work in the house, he ended up bringing me on to do a job. Well, that person moved up the ranks piece by piece by piece, ended up being a mid-Atlantic director for the company. This is a big company. This is not a small company. Once he was there, kind of the gates opened up. And we got all kinds of work, everything from $10,000 jobs to $50,000, $60,000 jobs, doing mitigation only, no rebuild, no anything. So we made one good impression with him, and that person got into a position at some point in time where they were able to be an area of influence, like we talked about a little bit yesterday, and opened the door for us to receive this work. And this work was worth hundreds of thousands of dollars at the end of the day. So it was a big, big contract, big agreement. But I didn't plan to necessarily joint venture with him. It's just I made sure that my reputation with him was so stellar that if an opportunity ever became itself, this person might be able to refer some work our way. And I essentially joint ventured with him in order to do it. Now, it's non-monetary. It's not compensated. There was nothing to do with that. But it had to do with developing emotional capital between myself and that particular referring source, and we worked out very well for quite some time working together, me doing the job, him calling us in and saying, I need an honest, legitimate company that can go in there and do the job correctly, honestly, fairly, and treat our clients, our customers, the tenants that are in there with the ultimate respect, because they deserve that, number one, and number two, you know, that's the right thing to do. It's just that there's no question around that. So make sure you maintain those joint venture relationships. Make sure you define and pinpoint who they are and who you need to be speaking to and who are people you can develop a relationship with, and then who then develop a program for maintaining that. If you need any, you have any questions about how to do that, I work with my clients and I do that all the time about how to maintain that and what to do to make sure A, B, C, D, and E, how the whole thing gets followed through on to make sure there's never going to be a loss of referring sources for yourself. I mean, that's something we can do. And if you want, feel free to post a question there. I'll be glad to answer it. And we'll go from there. All right, guys. Thank you so much for being here for episode number 62 of 10 Minute Kick-Ass Coaching. Just getting ready to do some running around, but I'm in my car today, and I decided it was best to try and shoot the video from here and discuss just that. So, guys, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. Have a good rest of the day, and we'll talk to you soon. And I understand we're going to have a little bit of a nor'easter here coming in tomorrow, so I think there's going to be some rain, wind, or possibly some snow. So we'll see what exactly happens. I know back in Pennsylvania, they're talking about a foot of snow, which is we're at the end of the year now with that. So good thing. The bad news is we're going to get it. The good news is it won't last for very long. All right. Have a great day. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.